respect it, because when I hear good shit, it makes me want to go make something, but not make something like what I just heard. Mm-hmm. That's the only difference.
Probably follows the story, and since he's not a Sony guy, he doesn't play. Reminds me kind of Dallas, like you said, where he'll like a series. Like, Dallas was like a big Sonic fan.
Yeah.
But he wasn't a Sega guy.
Yeah. And yeah, I understand that, because I'm not a Sony guy, but there's franchises that are that were exclusive to the Sony platform that I fucking love.
Oh yeah, I agree.
Ha!
I mean, like...
Or at the very least, they moved over to at least Xbox.
Like, when Crash was a thing, I was a fan of that.
Yeah.
Fucking... What else? Like you said, Final Fantasy V. Well, technically, Final Fantasy Tactics, the actual regular game, is still a thing, so.
Yeah.
But,
I mean, like, franchises as a whole.
Yeah, there were Legend of Dragoon, that's not really a franchise, but game, but that,
I enjoyed it, but I wouldn't say I'm a fan of it, but it's a good game, definitely.
I'm trying to think of something that Sony moves.
That's the hard one, dude. Like, to be honest. Personally, I feel that Sony first-party studios are kind of bad. Like, God of War, Gran Turismo.
I'm not a big...
Those are, like, the big games, and I think they're mediocre.
I did like Gran Turismo 1 and 2.
Yeah, 1 and 2 were excellent. I didn't like them so much because of the realism, but I liked how many cars were in the game, and it was just a different racing game. Different type of racing game.
I guess I can't really say Need for Speed because that ended up in peace. Holy shit, too.
Yeah, the first time I played Need for Speed was on 3DO, so.
Ooh, wow.
Yeah. And then, I had a friend that owned it on Saturn. That was back when it was called the Need for Speed.
Yeah. Okay, so that's like the first, like, game.
Yeah. Yeah, I think Sony's just always had great relationships with third party studios.
I would agree.
Like I said, the big hitters now, what I'm Uncharted. God of War, Gran Turismo, still like they're. I'm not saying they're bad games, dude, but to me, they're not. It's not no Mario or Zelda or Halo. It's not one of those big blockbuster fucking million selling. Maybe Uncharted.
Yeah, but
also.
That one, and this is just my opinion, that one to me is kind of like, we got Uncharted, and I'm like, bro, this is like half a game.
They took all the platforming and shit from Tomb Raider, and they took the gunplay from Gears, and neither of them are nearly as polished as either of those two games.
Exactly.
That's how I've always seen Uncharted. I liked it because I like Indiana Jones. I like the whole fucking searching the world for hidden treasures. And when Tomb Raider, was it the reboot came out last year? I'm gonna tell you that took everything Uncharted tried to do better than Tomb Raider and made it better than Uncharted.
I haven't played New Tomb. Last one I played a little bit of, the one before the anniversary edition of Part 1.
Probably Underworld.
Yeah, I played Underworld. Oh, man. That was the last one I played, and I only played a little bit.
Well, I will say that the reboot, Tomb Raider, when it came out like 2 years ago, that game... better than Underworld or Legend Anniversary. It's like fucking in a whole new league. But of course, Rise of the Tomb Raider this year is going to be Xbox and PC exclusive, and I can't wait.
I am definitely interested in that now that they've gotten the whole origin story of Lara out the way.
Yeah.
Now we can kind of see the badass on this. Like.
Yeah, according to synopses that I've read, the events of the first game, which was a reboot,
right,
is going to lead to a lot of skeptics, non believers, and that's basically what our goal is. And rather than Tomb Raider, proving what has been debunked and how that experience has changed her as a person, and basically what you're saying, becoming a badass.
Yeah.
And I just like how they did it, dude, because it's a reboot, but it's not remaking the first game. It literally started from the beginning, how she became to where she was in the first game.
Right. So now you can, if you want, you can literally do the entire versus games story. And it wouldn't issue.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm excited, dude. But yeah, this Sony. The first place I knew what I loved it, dude. I mean, 64 always had a special place in my heart, so the Dreamcast, and even the Saturn to a certain extent. The PlayStation was amazing.
Yeah, I'll still say I want all three. The Saturn had kind of a special place. The Sonic game. Plus Madden better than it was. Madden looked fucking great. And since that was even, since that was a better looking version with fucking licensing.
Final Fantasy and Metal Gear aside, because I really think it was the Square game and Metal Gear Solid that kept me on PlayStation.
Dude, I'd have to definitely agree with that. If they wouldn't have had those that Konami and Squaresoft support, I don't think the PlayStation would have done nearly as well. That's just my honest fucking. I mean, because they had a lot of third-party games. But if we think outside of the RPGs and MGS, and most of the big RPGs, obviously.
Yeah.
The platformers, come on.
Yeah.
All the platformers and adventure games do everything better on the system.
Oh yeah, and then the Saturn was the king for the fighters and the shooters.
Sports games, sorry, look like shit on PlayStation. If you might as well have played them on 64 or Saturn.
Yeah.
Probably Saturn because they usually got the licensing for their shit. Always. And the games look a lot better than the.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I can't even say Resident Evil, dude, because I did love Part 2.
Yeah.
It didn't come out on Saturn, but it did eventually make its way to the PlayStation 64, and I didn't like Part 3. So it wasn't. Oh, Saturn Hill was another one, though, dude. That was another great game.
Yeah, those games are definitely. That's another set of games that, I think turn the tide. But I think if you take away RPGs and MGS, I know the Square RPGs and MGS, that hurts PlayStation a lot.
In third place, I'd agree. The PlayStation was the perfect console without those games, without the good games, and that's what I never liked about Sony, was that they don't invest in first party, they rely on third party gimmicks. That's why the PS3 did so bad for so long.
Yeah.
The third party was shit until the end of the life. Like when they started getting all the Japanese games, all those quirky RPGs from Nippon Ichi and Hyper Dimension and all that shit, that's when people started paying attention from. But up to about like 2009, 2010, blah, blah, blah.
I would agree.
I mean, shit, dude, when the 360 was getting Tales of Vesperia and Blue Dragon and Lost Odyssey.
Bruh. I was like, dude, I'm thinking to myself, I don't need a fucking PS3 to play all this shit on my fucking 360. I mean, I had both, but, like, why would I even care?
Yeah, that's what I thought was weird, and it wasn't so much that I'm an Xbox fanboy, which I am. I'll fucking admit that.
Yeah.
Well, Xbox, Nintendo, Sega, everything but PlayStation. I was surprised to see Japanese developers grabbing the stranglehold on 360 when the PS3 was right there. Like, why?
You know what I thought was strange? You know, during the whole time of the 360's life cycle, we kept hearing the same thing. There's no Japanese support. And we kept getting Japanese support.
Yeah.
That was always the narrative. I was like, okay, let's say what this really is. There are no, people aren't really buying the systems in Japan. It's not that we're not getting support for the games, they are.
Yeah.
In Japan, the system just doesn't sell well.
It's xenophobia too. Japan won't buy it because it's not Japanese. And people are arguing at this point, why do iPhones sell so well? We don't fuck with it.
Yeah.
The Xbox 360 is an American console. Xbox One, the original Xbox, is just, no one's gonna buy it, dude.
And it's like, although some people would say, well, shit, Japan has a lot of things they support in America. Like, and like you said, things that are popular, yes. Pop culture-wise, popular. I mean, video gaming is still, to this day, a very niche. Like, it's slowly coming back to where it was, like, in the 70s and 80s. But it's not really something that a lot of people, society, I will say, will be like, oh, this is cool. Because it really isn't. You know?
Yeah.
So, even though the Xbox is really popular pretty much everywhere else, society as a whole doesn't see video gaming as this awesome thing to have to do or have to have. Whereas, and this is from the outside looking in, Japanese culture, you know, they like the fucking trendy, especially the whole youth thing. The trendy, fucking popular, fucking shit. Stuff that can be accessorized. So,
yeah.
And that's basically what the iPhones are. Fucking just accessories to you. Whatever. Exactly.
I mean, granted, it's not going to get as much Japanese support. I'll agree with that.
Yeah, I mean, we won't get a ton of those kind of quirky, no one knows what the fuck this is games.
Yeah, which for better or worse,
is it really?
You know, that's just how it is.
Yeah, and that's not really a bad thing. You know?
And I'm saying, dude, because I like some of the RPGs. Like this guy was great. I didn't really enjoy 2 or 3 too much, but I really did like the first game.
Yeah, but it's kind of like, you know, that will be the, the line that people will tell. And it's like, dude, I really don't care as long as we get the decent titles. Personally.
Yeah.
These little fucking...
That's how I look at it when it comes to those games. Just their Japanese-centric people hate shit. They're going to make them for PlayStation in Japan.
Kinda like,
I would love for some of those games, this guy across there, Project Crossbone, shit like that.
It's kinda like, yeah, I would love all those games.
Yeah, Project
Crossbone.
Yeah, Part 2 just got announced to come out this year on 3DS, so I am excited.
But like, yeah, I saw that trailer, looks pretty dope. I'm wondering what other characters are. But, for instance, you know, Capcom does the Sengoku Bizarro games. Like super high octane versions of Samurai Warriors. I prefer those games over Samurai. They're fucking amazing. But after we got 3, Capcom hasn't brought any more games over here. We only have Devil Kings, and then I think we got Part 2. But after that, you know, they just haven't brought new games over. But we haven't gotten 4 or Samuragi yet. Not going to. I'm like,
yeah.
There is an audience for this game. But Midway does have a stranglehold over that genre here in the States.
Definitely. People know what Warriors games are.
And they're kind of getting popular.
Speaking of that, dude, you know, Empires just came out on Xbox One and PS4. I didn't even know the game was a Dynasty Warrior 8 Empires. I didn't even know that game was a thing. And I'm like, dude, they're on like number fucking 7. Well, it's 8 here, but 7 in Japan.
Yeah.
And the games are still settling enough to put up next-gen consoles.
The games have been doing pretty good. I mean, it's pretty much just been strength of reputation. I don't know why the Dynasty Warriors games are so popular when the Samurai Warriors games have always been more streamlined and just better. But that everyone loves fucking Dynasty Warriors. That plays those.
See, I agree with you. Because Dynasty Warriors I've always liked as a beat 'em up aspect.
Yeah.
But in terms of story and setting, I don't care about ancient China, dude. I like the feudal area in Japan. I really like that shit.
And it's not just that for me. I do prefer the Sengoku era in that,
yeah,
in terms of the storytelling. I really don't like the romance of it. But just the gameplay, period. I know Dynasty Warriors gameplay has been, it is a little better than the movie, but I've always felt the Samurai Warriors gameplay better than the Samurai Warriors. The Dynasty Warriors. And because there's not so many characters, they can kind of play around a bit more with, characters' movesets and gameplay. Whereas Dynasty Warriors, you play as a million fucking people, so everything is some kind of. Yeah, a lot of copy and pasting. And I've always felt that every, series of Warriors should have an Empires-style game. I've always loved that. The taking over shit. Maybe not, the anime games, obviously, One Piece and North Star. But that could work well. I guess Gundam kind of already is, so you don't really have to do it. Because you do have units, you just can't control them, but, actually, no, it would be great for Gundam, too. Shit, you could do this. You could still do the storyline, but give you more control over what you do, because, it already has that Empire's feel to it. When you take over bases and shit, and, the units, your allies guard spots and stuff, it already kind of plays like Empire's. I would like it if they gave you a little bit more depth in those games. Empire's option. But I think any of those games could benefit from that shit. Because, honestly, just the regular story games for Dynasty Warriors are kind of stupid. You know?
Yeah, I don't like them. I don't like the story.
The story is cool, but kind of like cutscenes and all that shit. I'm like, dude, this is cool, but I don't even think Empires should be a separate game. They should just do Empires, and since it's just the same game, Empires should just have a story mode where it plays like normal Dynasty Warriors and with Empires mode.
They don't really need to have a separate game for Empires, dude. I've always felt like that.
You could just easily do that, and you could do that with all your fucking Warriors games in terms of, That should be something in Gundam. That should be in Dynasty Warriors. I wish they would do another fucking Strike Force game. Those are fucking dope. I've always said that Warriors Orochi, since that game should be Empires, period. Because everything about that game screams fucking army control and all that shit. Because every game, that's pretty much what you're doing in the missions. I've always thought that, but the game itself, the way they do it, so I can't really think of it. I'm looking forward to One Piece kind of sucking it up. The 3 upgrade sucked, and then we didn't get 4, and that actually upgrade 3, so what the fuck, I have this shit. And we already have the fucking upgrade for 4 that's coming out. Oh, damn, Capcom. Let me ask you a question. Is there a command on Twitch to take away moderator privileges?
Yeah, in the use space, not the use grant.
Okay, let me try that. Oh, there we go. That shit worked. Thank you.
Sure.
Yeah, because I made a friend a mod, and then I remembered that I can just go to my Nightbot settings and fucking make him a regular Nightbot. That way, the fucking Nightbot isn't spamming him.
Yeah.
Trying to do something. Oh, yeah, I can do that. That instead. Play Bloodborne yesterday. I'm not gonna lie, if I had a PS4, I probably would get this.
Yeah, I've seen gameplay, but well, my tastes are different. I'm not interested at all.
He was playing it. Seems easy. Yeah, it kind of was made to be. Dungeon.
I know Annabelle wants to play Borderlands pretty soon, but after that, I might stop by. Oh, that's how we're gonna hit you up, dude. So you're just gonna steal my burlap, huh? You know, Jack Burlap's like that.
Ha! Yeah, I did that for a title, man.
No, I don't mind. I thought it was funny. I was like, damn. Fucking Darren.
Spirit of friendship, Ray. Spirit of friendship. It's great friendship.
Yeah, no. Like I said, I'm not streaming shit. We can share that if I ever start up again. Yeah. I plan on Cole making guest appearances on your shit. I'm sure you'll make some on mine.
Yeah.
Our accounts. Like, I'll probably host your stream. Shit like that, so.
Yeah, I did that with, plan on doing that with, fucking Astro. Boy Logic. They're on if I'm fucking... Make sure I post their shit. I don't think I hosted it. I meant to. Didn't. But me and Astro. Xenoverse. Fuck, I'm. Ah, dude, man, I couldn't scream at this one. That would be angry.
Nah, not that old. Now they blocked the fucking cutscenes and shit.
Bro, in game, when they block something, you get that fucking big ass nasty looking burn on the screen.
Yeah.
Bro, I'm like, I need a capture card. This shit ain't.
I was playing Zack, and I was streaming a long time ago, and when it would block when I would open a treasure chest, because I guess it was considered a spoiler, like,
yeah.
What you find in certain locations, like, you're originally only allowed to stream gameplay, any cutscenes or anything that might be a secret, I guess, was blocked.
Yeah.
And I was like, dude, this is too much. The developers too much fucking freedom. I don't like that shit.
Blocking the cutscene. fucking shit where, like I said, that fucking gray square will pop up during game play.
Yeah.
Sometimes. Kind of blackout shit. Just, the fuck? Alright, this shit is.
Oh, yeah. Like. I mean, Xbox One, of course, is not as good as streaming with the capture card. But at least they have the decency to not do stupid shit like that. People that just wanted to get into streaming didn't want to buy any hardware, they can at least do that as a viable solution.
Yeah, speaking of that, I wanted to ask about that when you stream on Xbox One. Do they have any kind of layout shit like PS4 has? Kind of have a little freedom with the layout? Or is it just...
The only thing you can do is adjust where the camera's gonna be, and I believe, like, the little window for your Kinect.
Yeah.
And I believe you can either turn chat on the stream or turn it off. I think that's all you need.
Okay, so there is, like, a... All right. Password has been entered. Didn't kill Mike for now. Done!
Thank you.
Oh shit, he still has a cold. Fucking spawn. Motherfucker. Fuck it. Let's go. Spawn change. Oh my god, these spawns. No enemies. Fuck.
I got it.
Butterfly, and then I'll go ahead and finish up the dungeon. Damn it! Thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
What up, Grim? What's going on, man? I had to step out for a minute. Cooking some food. How you doing on this fine morning? Or is it not morning where you're at? Woo! Hold on, watch. Oh, I gotta make a meal for the day, so I had to go to the kitchen, make some stuff, and I was doing a little coffee thing where there's scrolling text, so perfect time to get up and start making my food. No! Let's see if I can run. I'm not a coffee guy myself, per cappuccino, but I kind of stay away from all that caffeine. Personally, I just don't like it. I like to drink juice and eating breakfast. I want to just make a really good breakfast and really healthy most of the time. Get some good juice, like some grapefruit juice. It's really bitter. Taste weight usually wakes me up. I can get a hold of it. I haven't really been much of a tea drinker though. Not a tea guy. What kind of tea do you like to drink? Green tea, black tea? Kind of preference. Oh my gosh, die! Get in this. See what I'm doing? Drinking a beer in the morning. Okay, alright. My ex-wife would like you. Dude, she freaking loves you. Can I get a butterfly, please? I need some PP. Motherfucker boss. Oh, I got mesmerized. Oh no. Oh my god, this is like the worst status to have right now. Let's see if I isn't nauseous. Sunstroke feeling. Honestly, alright, this fight might not be easy at all. Oh, I think I might have some trouble. Oh my god. I think like that beat at all. Oh my god. Alright, let's see. Alright, Flash. This is not cool. Brilliant Age Sprout. Please. Oh, nice. Give me the PP. From this. Oh, there goes Jeff. has been the worst fight. PB for myself. I should have fully recovered. Fight, Mr. Drilling an H sprout there. Be right back, bro. Oh man, it made you feel reborn. Yes, it brought us back to life. Oh my god. Yes. I got a lot of money though. That's pretty sweet. Get about 3,000. Wish I had that much. Reels. I can use that kind of cash. Okay, we're gonna need. some secret herbs. Yes. They're awesome. Let's get some peanut cheese bars. You know, as many times as I've played Earthbound, this is probably the first playthrough I've played where I've bought items this time. I usually power level. Do this much buying. First time I bought items. Got the. Save, and then I'm gonna fight this boss again. No, I'm not waiting. Seven coins. Okay, cool beans. Give this because I like. Out. Even fix some of it. Yummy. I'd like to say, yes, I'd like to sleep in that weird chair table thingy that I'm obviously sleeping in. Sure. I love Saturn Rally. It's such a. Running on the screen. Anytime now. Anytime now. There we go. This is the man I was looking for. Yes, I can cover up. You can just take a bat. Bye-bye, Escargo. Bye-bye. Okay. Hey, these guys, hurry up and make them. Me, I'm deader than dead. That was a waste. Spawn, work with me. I need to reset the spawn. Oh god. Even worse. Come on. Get it on right. I just have had no luck with it. Two of my party members. The fuck? These secret herbs. I'm upset with myself. I just killed him. Got it out the way. Now I'm just retarded status. Yeah, I'm just gonna go all out. Right from the beginning of the fight. Kobo's gonna start messing. Kill it. In control of my thought. Oh! Here goes. Crazy controls. It don't just reverse either, man. They go in like all kinds of different freaking directions. It is really hard to move. Once. Mushrooms really kick. The worst. Shield Sigma, sweet. I finally get to get rid of this retarded, awful status. There we go. Up is right, right is down, left is up. No more. No bueno. Hate the status. Okay. third segment. Second, and Peaceful Rest Valley. Skip that one. Back. Status of Jeff. Thank you, Hot Springs. Party's home. Now we can go to Fourth Side. Our awesome thing.
Thank you.
Alright, I'm back. What up? Gotta check on food. Alright. Awesome. Oh. Crap. Music. Probably should turn it off. And I need a new computer desk. The thing is lacking. Tucson. Never mind. go back to 3 first, then go back to 2 soon, then take out boss. Hello. I don't know teleport yet, and it's gonna be a while before I get it. Ha ha ha! Nice. Let's just kill these guys for go, guys, let's go. I came up here for a reason. Okay, cool. Waterfall. God, he's so fast, man. Coming through in the clutch. So awesome. So very illegal. Not really. But oh. gotta think right. So freaking best audio memory. Yeah, yeah. That's why I hate when I get a bad spawn. At least this, the good thing I'll say about Earthbound is that since you see the enemies, you can effectively change the spawn by moving on to another screen and basically making the game load another piece of the area. And you can get rid of the enemy. Doesn't always work to your favor, but you can kind of play with that a bit. With games like Pokemon and like Final Fantasy, where the battles just happen randomly. It, yeah, you can't really do that. Oh, I got an achievement. Sweet. These are free, right? You know, it's cool that they were there to congratulate me, but they're still kind of hanging out in the graveyard. Not cool. Not cool. Guys, this is still a graveyard. Let's try it, Don. Alright. Some of the easy achievements I'm gonna have to come back and do. Welcome back to Tucson. Awesome. Be back. Good too. Alright. Find us a boss. Wait. Run away, territorial oak. Fun. Love being able to affect the spawn. We barely won. Jeff legit died. He legit was dead. That was so awesome. Retro achievements. I might have to look to you. Retro. That'd be kind of cool. Gosh, I made Rust Valley. Was that car painter? Didn't even know he showed back up here. Holy shit. Wow. Learned something. I've never came back here. Wait. Bro.